وصلی اللہ علی النبی الکریم. رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. دس ٹاک از اباؤٹ دی پرافٹ آف اسلام, سم آسپیکٹ آف ہز لائف اینڈ ہز ٹیچنگس. ون امریکن اسکالر ڈاکٹر مائیکل ہارٹ ہیز پبلشڈ اے بک ود دی ٹائٹل دا ہنڈریڈ. In this book, he has listed 100 personalities of the history, those who were super achievers. So in this list of 100, he puts the Prophet of Islam at the top. He puts the Prophet of Islam at the top. He says in this book about the Prophet that Muhammad was supremely successful man on both the secular and religious levels. Muhammad was the supremely successful man in the history on both the religious and secular levels. So according to his findings, the Prophet of Islam was successful not only in religious field but also in secular fields. Here I would like to say something in one aspect of his life, that is his success in secular field. It is my finding that Prophet of Islam was not only a successful person, a supremely successful person in the history, at the same time he gave the formula of supreme success. He has given the formula of supreme success. I think it is more important. He himself was not a super achiever, but he has given the formula of super achievement, super success. So here I would like to mention some aspect of that formula. In the Quran, you know, the Quran was revealed to the Prophet of Islam from God Almighty. So the main source of Prophet's thinking and behavior was the Quran itself. So in the Quran there is a verse very, very important for every human being. It reads, Inna ma'al usri yusra, Inna ma'al usri yusra. With every hardship there is ease, with every hardship there is ease. This verse is repeated in the Quran. So the Prophet of Islam explained this repetition in these words. He said, لَنْ يَغْلِبَ عُسْرٌ إِسْرَائِنَ لَنْ يَغْلِبَ عُسْرٌ إِسْرَائِنَ. It's very important, very, very important. According to this prophetic saying, the quantum of opportunity is double than the quantum of problem. In our world, the opportunities are double than the problems. So why anxiety? Why frustration? Why tension? Why stress? You have to avail all those abundant opportunities. If you are facing some problem, you have to believe in advance that there are opportunities double than the problems. So it is a good tiding for you. Good tiding for you. It's very, very important for every human being, for every man and woman. Because every day we face some problems. So when we face some problem, we have to believe in advance that there are opportunities more than the problem. So we have to avail these opportunities. And we will be a success. This is the 31st March issue of the Hindustan Times. Today it is 31st of March. So this day, that is this issue, that is the issue of 31st March. There is a report about Indian Muslims. About Indian Muslims. This report is based on a national survey. On a national survey about the economic conditions of the Muslims living in India. It is a very hopeful report. Also, there is a very, very important principle that verify the principle of given that verify the principle given by the Prophet of Islam. The report says that after 1947, there was some discrimination against the Muslims in job, in organized sector. In jobs, in the organized sector. So there was discrimination against the Muslims. Then what happened? Gradually, there was a change among the Muslim thinking. When they saw that there is no hope in organized sector, they adopted to seek jobs in self-employed sector. They were denied of jobs in organized sector, but after some years they regain their position in self-employed sector. This is very important. This verifies the principle given by the Prophet of Islam. The formula given by the Prophet of Islam is not something as mysterious. It is based on the law of nature. The formula given by the Prophet of Islam is based on the law of nature. It is not mysterious. Now, what is that law of nature? That law of nature is that when a community is denied of jobs or any kind of opportunities, so this denial or this discrimination becomes a challenge for him. You know, it is law of nature that every discrimination becomes a challenge in result, and challenge always enhances the ability of the community. So when Muslims were denied jobs in organized sector, it was for them it was a challenge. This challenge was like a brainstorm. Their nature wanted to face, their nature wanted to meet this challenge. It was but natural that they wanted to face, to meet this challenge. So this tendency was very, very important for their future, because this increased their creativity. So the community became a creative community. If previously they were simply a community, now they became a creative community. What a good news! Before discrimination, or so-called discrimination, I will say that so-called discrimination, they were simply a community, a normal community, an ordinary community. But now, they are a creative community. That so-called discrimination only increased their creativity according to the law of nature. There is a very relevant illustration of the principle given by the Prophet of Islam, that when you are faced with some problem, it will increase your creativity. It is this fact that it is a law of nature. So there is no mystery. It's not mysterious. Discrimination or any kind of disadvantage is a blessing in disguise. Is a blessing in disguise. It only increases your intellectual development, your creativity, your ability. So challenge makes a man Superman. So it is this fact that Prophet of Islam has said in these words that لَنْ يَغْلَبَ عُسْرٌ يُسْرَيْنِ. If it means that the quantum of opportunity is always double than the quantum of problem, then there are other principles given by the Prophet of Islam. One such principle is that tisatu ashari rizq fi tijara, tisatu ashari rizq fi tijara. It means that business is in business, it means that in business there are 90 times more opportunities than any other time for earning. Earning depends 90 times more in business than any other job. Here you can see that it is a very good, it is a hopeful sign for anyone, because business is a free exercise. If you were denied in job, in service, then you have to think that the field of business is open, field of commerce is open. You can try your destiny in is business, in commerce, and that is 90% of your, and from this field you can earn 90% more earning than with the job. So it's also a very good formula. It means that there is no frustration at all in life. You fail to find a job, if you fail to find a service, there is no room for frustration. Because the field of business is open, field of commerce is open. Services are limited, jobs are limited, but business is not limited, commerce is not limited. So this is a message of hope. In this saying, the Prophet gave us a message of hope. It means that if you are denied of services, don't be frustrated, because you can try in some other job, you can try in some other fields, field of commerce, and you will be successful. Then there is a saying of the Prophet of Islam, is also very important for every human being, for every man and woman. اٹ از افضل العبادت انتظار الفرج. افضل العبادت انتظار الفرج. اٹ مینس دیٹ اٹ از آلسو این عبادہ وے آف ورشپ ٹو ویٹ فار سم مور اپرچونیٹیز. ان ادر ورڈس ویٹ اینڈ سی پالیسی, اڈاپٹنگ ویٹ اینڈ سی پالیسی از عبادہ. واٹ اے گڈ نیوز. ایوری ٹائم یو فیس سم فیلئر یو ہیو ٹو اڈاپٹ دا پالیسی آف ویٹ اینڈ سی, ویٹ اینڈ سی. سو دس پالیسی از ناٹ سمپلی اے پالیسی, اٹ آلسو عبادہ, اٹ آلسو ورشپ. اینڈ ایکسپیرئنس شوز دیٹ ایوری ٹائم یو اڈاپٹ دس پالیسی, اٹ از شیور شاٹ فار یور لائف. یو نیور لوز. دس پالیسی مینس واٹ یو ہیو فیل ٹو گین ان یور پریزنٹ یو کین گین اٹ ان فیوچر. تو اٹ از فیوچر اورینٹڈ پالیسی. افضل العبادت انتظار الفرج مینس, افضل العبادت انتظار الفرج مینس اڈاپٹ فیوچر اورینٹڈ پالیسی. ڈونٹ سی ان دا پاسٹ اینڈ آلسو ڈونٹ اسٹک ٹو دا پریزنٹ, بٹ آلویز اڈاپٹ فیوچر اورینٹڈ پالیسی. اٹس ویری امپورٹنٹ. سو دیر از نو روم فار فرسٹریشن. وین یو ہیو, اف یو ہیو فیلڈ ان پریزنٹ, یو ہیو ٹو بی ہوپ فل دیٹ یو ویل بی سکسیس ان فیوچر. ویری سمپل فارمولا. And Prophet of Islam says that it is a worship, it is an ibadah. It is also a formula. At the time, it is a formula, and at the same time it is a worship. This principle tells you that this policy is a worldly policy, at the same time it is an ibadah, it is a worship. So it's very good. The Prophet of Islam always speaks in language of hopes. He never spoke in the language of frustration. Prophet of Islam was history's greatest optimist. History's greatest optimist. He never used the language of pessimism. There is a verse in the Quran that لا تیأسوا من روح اللہ, لا تیأسوا من روح اللہ. ڈونٹ بی فرسٹریٹڈ فرام دی بلیسنگ آف گاڈ. آلویز ہوپ فار بلیسنگ. ڈونٹ گو ٹو فرسٹریشن. سو ان اسلام فرسٹریشن is haram. Islam is a hopeful religion. Islam is based on optimism rather than pessimism. So it gives you a great courage in the life. Great courage that God is with you. You know the Prophet of Islam, when when he migrated from Mecca to Medina, so in the way he spent some time in the cave of mountain Sour. So at that time, Meccan people were enemy. They wanted to kill him. So they were, when he migrated from Mecca to Medina, they were in search. They wanted to kill him. So what happened? They reached to the mouth of the cave. They managed to reach to the mouth of the cave. So at that time, Abu Bakr Siddiq was with him. He said, "O Prophet, they reached here also." So according to the Quranic report, Prophet of Islam has said, "La tahzan inna Allah ma'ana." Don't fear, God is with us. It was a very, very critical situation. At that time, Prophet was apparently very helpless person. Apparently, he was a helpless person. But at the same time, he felt that God is with him. So he said, "La tahzan inna Allah ma'ana." Don't fear, God is with us. This is a great example he gave for us, that in every time you don't need to be hopeless. Every time you have to live in conviction, in courage. And his courage was based on this belief that God with him, God is with him. His hope, his courage was not simply a wishful thinking. It was based on a high belief, on a real belief that God is with him. God Almighty is with him. God Almighty is with him. So this was a source of conviction for him. This is an example we find in the Prophet of Islam. This gives us a light. This gives us a courage. This gives us an eternal hope. The Prophet of Islam was a super achiever. There is no doubt about it. But at the same time, he gave us the formula of super achievement. He was not only as a person successful. No. He was a guide. He was a prophet. So although personally he was a supremely successful man, but at the same time, in letter and practice both, he gave us a formula of supreme success. Then the Prophet of Islam has said, "Ela manna nasr ma sabr." It means that patience is bracketed with success. Ela manna nasr ma sabr. If you want success, you have to be patient. If you want success, you have to be patient. Why? It is law of nature. In this world is governed by the law of nature. Nothing is at random in this world. World war created by God, and the world is controlled by him, and the world is completely under the law of nature. So this is the law of nature, that success comes to you gradually, not suddenly. If you want a tree, if you want a garden, you cannot have a garden suddenly, but you have to sow seed in the soil, or saplings in the soil. Then you have to wait up to 10 years, 20 years, sometime 100 years. So it is the law of nature. If you want success, you have to wait, because success comes to you gradually, not suddenly, not abruptly. No one can, be owner of a garden suddenly. No. If you want to have a garden, you have to wait. This is the law of nature. So Prophet of Islam said, "Ela manna nasr ma sabr." Success is bracketed with patience. Without patience, there is no success in this world. Without patience, there is no success in this world. Success is for those who prove to be patient. So Prophet of Islam said that without patience, there is no success. Without patience, there is no achievement. Alam anna nasr ma sabr. Now, sabr is not simply a passive attitude. No. Sabr means patient planning. Sabr means well-considered planning. Sabr means well-considered plannings. So if you want to achieve some success, you have to plan. Without planning, you cannot do anything. All the factories, all the industries, all those organizations are outcome of planning. All the successes are outcome of planning. So planning needs patience, sabr. Sabr means patience. So success needs planning, and planning needs sabr. So without sabr, there is no patient thinking. Without sabr, there is no planning. Without planning, there is no great success. And Prophet of Islam was great, great sabir, man of patience. Fasbir kama sabara ulul azmi min ar-rusul. It is a Quranic verse. Be patient, just as other prophets. All the prophets adopted patience. So, you have to adopt patience. This is the Quranic verse. Fasbir kama sabara ulul azmi min ar-rusul. All the prophets of God adopted patience. So you have to adopt patience. Without patience, there is no success. So sabr is not simply a passive attitude. Sabr is not cowardice. Sabr is not inaction. Sabr is action, but with planning. Sabr is not inaction. Sabr is an action. Sabr is an activity, but activity with planning, action with planning, this is sabr. So when you want to achieve great success, you have to be patient. This is the Prophet's saying, Ela man nasr was sabr. So in Islam, fasting is nothing but a training of sabr. The Prophet of Islam has said about fasting, there is a psalm that Huwa shahrus sabr. Huwa shahrus sabr. Psalm or fasting is the month of patience. Psalm or fasting is a month of patience. So through psalm, through fasting, through roza, you are trained for patience. Patience is so important that God made him a ibadah. Patience in Islam, sabr is an ibadah. It's not simply a technique. Sabr is an ibadah. Innama yuwaffas sabirun ajrahum bighair hisab. But sabr is a supreme ibadah. Sabr is a supreme worship. So sabr is a formula of success, great success. Supreme success. One who want to be a super achiever, he must adopt sabr, that is patience. This is the advice of the Prophet of Islam. So Prophet of Islam was supremely successful man in religious field and spiritual field, as well as in worldly field, in secular field. Aqulu qawli hadha. واستغفر اللہ لی ولکم اجمعین.